The winners will be announced November the 16th. Each will get $15,000. For years, scientists have known that BSE causes variant Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, what some people call the human form of mad cow disease. But another form of CJD, sporadic CJD, has always confounded them. The most common theory has been that the deadly illness occurs spontaneously with no known cause. Now, some of the world's leading scientists in the field are having another look at sporadic CJD and the possibility that it, too, is linked to mad cow. Here's Kelly Crow with a feature report.
It starts out slowly. At first, the victims don't know what's wrong with them. They can't put their finger on it. They keep making little mistakes. The spelling mistakes that just look sloppy. Numbers become easily confused. The words on the page become blurry. It's the beginning of a terrifying slide into dementia and death. That's what happened to Jeff Schwann. Little by little, his brain was ravaged by a disease so rare, his mother had never even heard of it.
And finally, on August 11th, we received words you'll never want to hear. He has a disease that has no treatment and no cure. And we just tried to take that in.
Checked eye movements, look right here at my finger.
It was Dr. Norman Foster who discovered the terrible truth. He specializes in diseases of the brain.
Go right into the crease of your thumb.
And he's the one who finally figured out what was wrong with Jeff Schwann.
The major problem was a seizure disorder, and that was investigated and treated, but despite treatment, he became progressively worse. And it was unclear at the time what was causing these seizures, and it was suspected that this was due to an encephalitis or meningitis or some other problem. And I strongly advocated that everything be done to identify what the cause of this is. And that led to a brain biopsy. When we examined the tissue under the microscope, we were somewhat surprised to find evidence of Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease.
Jeff Schwann died from a mysterious illness called sporadic Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, or sporadic CJD. It's a rare and fatal brain-wasting disease that seems to strike out of nowhere. But was it really just bad luck that killed this healthy 26-year-old man? Or is there another explanation? Sporadic Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease is a type of prion disease. Prions are proteins found in humans and other mammals. But when an altered form of the prion appears, it somehow starts a critical chain reaction, turning healthy prions into deadly ones that ultimately destroy the brain. Prion diseases are always fatal. There is no cure, no treatment. And science now knows that prion diseases can be spread by eating meat. It was first realized here in Papua New Guinea back in 1957, where a brain-wasting disease called kuru was sweeping through a tribe of cannibals. Scientists realized these people were developing kuru after feasting on the remains of their dead, who were already infected. It was the first evidence that prion diseases could be spread through eating infected material. Thirty years later, British cattle began developing a prion disease. It was called BSE, or mad cow disease. It was spread when the animals ate feed made from diseased cattle. Then young Britons began dying, and scientists realized humans could catch a prion disease from eating infected beef. That disease is called variant CJD. So far, it has claimed 170 victims. But none of that seems to explain what happened to Jeff Schwann. He had the other prion disease, the one that is thought to strike at random, so-called sporadic CJD. Like the other prion diseases, the brain fills with sponge-like holes. But scientists don't know what causes sporadic CJD. And some are asking, could it also be caused by eating meat? Here's one possible clue. The disease sometimes shows up in clusters, in people who live near each other. It happens too often to be explained only by chance. British epidemiologist Simon Cousins worked on two scientific studies that documented clusters of the disease in both England and France. The studies concluded that it must be caused by something on the outside, that it can't be just a spontaneous disease.
The spontaneous event would be doesn't really explain why there might be clustering. So the clustering is pointing one in the direction of thinking from time to time people are exposed to a common external source.
One common external source? Infected meat. It's a frightening possibility that is being actively investigated by some European scientists. Here in Switzerland, there was an epidemic of mad cow disease in the 1990s, and now they're seeing a more than doubling in the rate of sporadic CJD. Swiss scientists think there might be a connection.
What we need to find out is whether the whole problem of the enhanced Creutzfeldt-Jakob does indeed have something to do with mad cow's disease. But we certainly did have our definite window of exposure, and so if we had BSE 10 years ago and now we have enhanced Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, it's unavoidable to ask the question whether the two phenomena are related.
Dr. Adriano Aguzzi is one of the world's experts on prion diseases. He says he has ruled out most of the other explanations, and now his main working hypothesis is that at least some sporadic CJD in Switzerland could be another form of human mad cow disease.
But this by no means excludes that BSE may manifest itself in humans with different phenotypic characteristics. And maybe BSE in Switzerland is also different from BSE in the UK. And then variant CJD will also be different. So I think from the UK experience, it's impossible to draw the conclusion that BSE will only give rise to what we know as variant CJD.
What it means is cattle infected with prion disease might be causing sporadic CJD. To find out, the scientists are trying to match the tissue from infected Swiss cattle with the tissue from Swiss victims. If the tissue looks the same on the lab tests, then it will be strong evidence the two are connected. Right next door in Italy, they might have already made that connection. Dr. Gianluigi Zanusso was studying the brains from BSE-infected cattle when he noticed a form of the disease he'd never seen before. He realized it was a new form of mad cow disease. It was the first time scientists realized there could be more than one kind of prion disease in cattle.
So our assumption is that since there is this strict biochemical similarities together with the disease phenotype, we think that there might be a connection between the two.
Dr. Zanusso got a second shock when he ran the new cattle prion through the lab tests. It looked exactly like sporadic CJD. he could hardly believe his eyes. He was looking at possible proof that humans could catch a second prion disease from cattle.
Yes, this is only a biochemical evidence, because at the beginning, when BSE has been discovered and the variant CJD have been discovered in the UK, they found that the signature, I mean the biochemical pattern of both BSE and variant, were similar. We found the same biochemical expert, so there are pathological similarities and molecular similarities.
There is still one more step to prove the link. This new strain of BSE will be injected into mice that have human genes. It will take 2 years. But the results will bring scientists a little bit closer to the answer of whether sporadic CJD is caused by meat.
I think that that is a possibility. Personally, I would say that it's possible that some of the cases are caused. I mean, maybe what we call sporadic CJD is a collection of different diseases, and some of it could actually be transmission of BSE.
It might be a possibility, because it is an infectious disease. I mean, if you get a piece of brain of this amyloidogenic or classical CJD and you inoculate whatever animal, you transmit the disease. But on the other side, it's not so far clear whether the animals transmit the disease to man.
Scientists agree that cattle prion disease must be kept out of the human food supply. The problem is finding it before the animal is slaughtered. Bitter experience has already proven that the disease can be lurking, even as officials boast that their herd is BSE free. After years of making those claims, the U.S. has had to admit to a homegrown case of BSE in a Texas cow this past June. And that case was discovered only after testing was dramatically increased. And yet, the U.S. and Canada are still only testing cattle that look sick. And with that kind of testing and millions of animals slaughtered every year, the disease is easy to miss, a lesson the Italians already learned.
In Italy, they didn't know for sure that they had mad cow disease until they started testing not just the animals that look sick, but every single animal over 24 months that goes into the food chain. Now, 4 years later, they've only had one animal that looks sick, but they found more than 130 cases of mad cow disease in healthy-looking animals. In other words, if they hadn't been testing, those 130 animals would have gone into the food chain.
In North America, they're only looking at symptomatic cases.
It is.
So they could be missing
sure
a lot of disease.
Sure. They take only neurological cattle, cattle with neurological symptoms, or downer cattle. So this is the so-called passive surveillance, that when you have neurological, you make the potential diagnosis of CJD. And the only way to get rid of this is that all the animals should be tested. And people at least buy a piece of meat to say, this is BSE free.
Dr. Adriano Aguzzi says the United States isn't trying hard enough to find prion disease in its cattle.
I think that in North America there is a huge problem, because North America has refused for many years to put in place any kind of serious surveillance of cattle. And I think this is a disgrace, and it really cries to heaven. But the fact that particularly the U.S. Has just refused to even take into consideration the possibility that BSE may be prevalent is a huge problem.
It's also not clear how widespread sporadic CJD is. The final diagnosis can only be made after death by examining the brain in an autopsy. But today, autopsies are rarely done. And although sporadic CJD is a rare condition, estimated at one in a million, Dr. Norman Foster suspects the rate is higher.
In many states in the United States, if a physician suspects a case, they can report it as a public health problem, but there's no mechanism to investigate or no way to pursue this in a systematic way.
So you could be missing lots of cases.
So we are missing lots of cases.
Jeff Schwann is on the official record as just another unfortunate victim of a rare disease that seems to strike for no reason. And for his mother, it is the unanswered questions that weigh most heavily on her shoulders.
So all of these people who are dying of sporadic CJD, they don't have an answer for it. It's very, very frustrating because we want answers.
To get those answers, she must wait for the slow, deliberate pace of science. Kelly Crowe, CBC News, Sterling Heights, Michigan.
When we come back, we'll have this story.
This medal, although given to one man, is physical testament to the sacrifices of many unnamed men.
This man was a hero of the First World War. Almost a century later, his family continues to honor him and to live by his example. Tonight, field trip. BC's teachers take their case straight to the provincial legislature, and the premier is striking back.
Teachers are clearly in contempt of court.
Heavy lifting.
We are like a toy store for the thieves.
The multi-million dollar crime wave that's built brick by stolen brick.